Everyone, we do something similar in Russian. In Russian, can you hear? Okay, if you have problems, you can get closer. We are reading for Russian group book, a book that is not translated in Russian yet. And I have it, this book in English, and I read and translate as I read to Russian group. And many people in Russia are very interested because it is Elder Aemilianos, who you know probably, everybody knows about him and his legacy, right? His legacy is still hidden. It's not everything is published probably, and things are still being published little by little. And of course, first they publish it in Greek, and then from Greek language, they come. Some books are being translated in English, other books are translated in Russian, and it's not the same books. Those are different books. So what we do for Russian people, we translated Mystical Marriage, and we are reading. We have these readings on Sundays. We are about half book through, and people look, we do recordings, and people in Russia are watching and also very interested, because this book is not translated in Russian yet. And here is another book, which is very interesting, which we're gonna try to read. And this book is not translated in English yet. And it is translated in Russian privately. So it is not, I don't think it is published in Russia either. So this book is still on its way to the reader, but it is published in Greek. So we will try to read it and get it available for English speakers ahead of time, because who knows? As he says here, we don't know how long we're gonna live, you know? The time of this life is so short, so we try to use it for learning, for reading this book before it even came out. So what is this book about? This is texts on watchfulness and holiness. This is how it sounds in English translation, in Thelakalia. This is from Thelakalia, the volume one.
What is it, watchfulness?
Трезвение. И святость. This is one of the most famous books from Philokalia. It is talking primarily about prayer and, of course, about watchfulness. And whole Philokalia is a collection of the books on watchfulness. But this one is respected especially in monastic communities and people who are trying to pray, trying to live spiritual life. And now Elder Aemilianos doing his talks to the monastics in the monastery of Simona Petra, where he was an abbot, was explaining this book. interpreting it. And his explanations are very, very interesting. It adds so much depth to what he is talking about that it becomes like another text, like based on this, but he opens so many other things, and it is very inspiring and very interesting. All these talks were recorded on the audio tapes, and now little by little they are getting that that information. Somebody takes, writes, and this is how we have his books today, because he wasn't, as far as I know, he wasn't writing any books on paper. He was just talking, and all the books we have from him based on those audio tapes. And we're starting. We will skip preface and we will just jump in. So in English it says, "On watchfulness and holiness, written for Theodolos." But here, as soon as we start, we see a little differences, and I will point on the differences in the translation because it's very interesting. In Russian, which is, I assume, closer to the Greek version, original one, it sounds like this. The word very beneficial for the soul, very good for soul, and salvific. About vigilance and main virtue. Okay, guys, you can come. Come. Yeah, hello. We are still have people coming. They hear it. In Church Slavonic, in older texts, it sounds even a little bit different. It says the word, like beneficial for soul, salvific, about watchfulness as main virtue. So there is no holiness at all in Russian translation, and I assume in Greek also there is no holiness. This is interpretation of the somebody who translated this, but it's all in line. I mean, this is not that bad. Okay, so this word which is beneficial for soul and salvific, about watchfulness and main virtue, considered to be written by Saint Hesychi, the priest of Jerusalem, who used to live at the end of 4th and beginning of 5th century. And here, this was in quotes, the name of this book, and now immediately we are reading explanation of Elder Aemilianos. But because we found different terminology in his texts, people came to conclusion that probably this text was written much later than 4th century. And probably it was adjusted and changed a little bit here and there from some later author. But following the tradition, according to tradition, we are still accepting these texts as texts of Saint Hesychi, who is writing them to some Feodul. Nothing is being said about this Feodul or his life, and only because of content of these texts, that they are like spiritual and very high spiritual topics, we can assume that this Feodul was a monk and was a person of spiritual searches. He was trying to live a spiritual life. But in reality, in fact, Saint Isihi, he is writing not only to Theodore, but also to every soul. First of all, of course, he is writing to monks. Well, why to monks? Because for monks, this is priority. This is their job, to live in prayer, to work, labor in prayer, labor in spiritual things. And then after that, to every flesh, because we all called by God to this divine wedding, to this king's wedding. And he is saying, this is from Matthew chapter 22, verse 2. That's where that parable starts. From about how king called people to the wedding. Remember, he prepared a lot of meals, food, and called everyone. But people said, oh, you know, I'm busy here, I'm busy there, and nobody came. And then he invited, he got a little upset, and he then invited like everybody who they were able to find. Well, homeless people, everyone. And then the wedding was full of people. And then there was one guy, you remember, this is from this parable, who wasn't dressed properly. By the way, it's again about dressing in the church, you see? We again coming back to this proper dressing in the church. So one guy wasn't dressed properly, and he was like cast out from the wedding. We all called to this enjoyment, to this sweetness of heavenly kingdom, to acquiring the sacraments which are hidden in God from the beginning of the world. This is in Ephesians 3:9, which are given to us and open to us. Given to us, there is also to the Matthew where Christ says about parables. When apostles were asking him, he said, it is given to you to see the mysteries of kingdom of heaven, and to others, it is not given. So this is given to us. So this word, meaning these texts, this word is some kind of way, which leading us right to the way of the Lord in life of spiritual aspiration. From the very beginning, the author is showing us the approach, method by which we will not suffer a fail at our walking towards God. In order we not to lose, so to say, not a single footprint of His, God's presence. This word also will help us in the case if we, with the help of God's grace, already acquired some kind of spiritual measure, if we already like on this way. In order to now, with more fast rhythm and more fast movement, we would reach our goal, Because the years of our life are passing by very quick, very quickly. Of course, from Old and New Testament, and from the life of saints, we see sometimes that it is possible to acquire God in one moment. It happens sometimes like right away. That the streams of grace from God are just flood us, flood the people. So when we study this word, these texts, even if like without big desire or with some difficulties, we are feeling very strong attraction and calling to life, to live with God, to be with God. This was a little note on just on the name of the book. And now he starts. I took this so I don't try to translate the book itself. So here is the Philokalia and Hesychion watchfulness. He will take little pieces and we'll talk about them. Watchfulness is a spiritual method. This is how it's translated in English. In Russian, it is a little different. In Russian, it sounds like this. Watchfulness is spiritual art. Despite he gives the, in parentheses, he gives the Greek original words, it's methodos pneumatiki. So in Greek, it is kind of method, but I suspect that in Greek language, the meaning of this word is a little different than in English and in Russian. Because in English and Russian, method is something more technical. Right, if I'm correct. Mm-hmm. Art is more like from the area of creation and being creative. So I suspect that in Greek, maybe wrong, not specialist there, but this is the only reason I can see why it was translated as an art in Church Slavonic and very early texts in Russian and in contemporary too. And by the explanation which we will read further, you will see that the meaning that Elder Aemilianos is talking about is closer to art, to something more like creative things. So watchfulness is a spiritual method. He will talk only about this now. Now Elder Aemilianos. Author is starting his texts from the word watchfulness, which has not some kind of undefined meaning, but means activity, actions, or even better to say, labor, doing something. Labor of all our life. Our apostolic calling. Work and our life, let's say, and our breathing, which provides us by doing it. I'm sorry for that. This probably sounds terrible in English, I know, but I'm trying to deliver meaning. If you don't get something, you just ask, okay, if I'm going like too far. Okay. Which this is a little difficult place to, sometimes it's hard to translate, which provide us the monastery atmosphere, the atmosphere that which we find in monasteries. Why we feel like this special place, why we feel grace. It's really when you get to the monastery, you feel a different atmosphere, right? And this is what he's talking. The cause why there is this special atmosphere, besides that, of course, the, you know, God gives a special blessing for this place, but it is also people who live there and who practice prayer and practice watchfulness. So spiritual atmosphere is kind of cleaned by this work of their minds. It is like if we would stop breathing and the life-giving air would stop entering us, then we would die. Even if for one moment we will not have watchfulness, the entrance in our being of life-giving wind of Holy Spirit will stop. If for one moment we are not having watchfulness, the Holy Spirit stops coming to us. We just, like, we cannot, our soul cannot breathe. And we were talking about this, right, with kids yesterday. You know, do you know this place from Saint Simeon the New Theologian about why is this, why he is talking about Holy Spirit and why he is comparing it to the air and life? You know, Saint Simeon the New Theologian is talking about death of the body and death of the soul, saying that death of the body, what is death of the body? Yesterday I asked kids, and this little boy, one of the little boys, I think it was Seraphim's son, he gave like perfect answer. I want to see if somebody now gives besides
no more him, breathing. Because we no were more breathing. It stops.
Not exactly. Well, in a way, yes, but any other versions? He was right away. This is when soul leaves body, right? When soul leaves body, this is the death of the body. Body is dead. There is nobody inside. Soul gone. And then what is the death of the soul? This is when Holy Spirit leaves the soul. So people can seem alive, go to work, have career, do different activities, have fun, but the soul is dead. Why? Because there is no Holy Spirit. Mm-hmm. And he talks more about, you can read, it's Simeon the New Theologian, very interesting. He talks about Adam, on the example of Adam. When he sinned, his soul died immediately after fall. And then his body lived like 900 years. So this is why, you see, he is comparing these things. Same like for our body, the air, if we stop breathing, we will die with our body. If Holy Spirit stops coming to our soul, like a spiritual air, our soul dies, dead. Not having Holy Spirit, we will find ourselves in suffocating atmosphere, suffocating, not without any grace, without joy, without stillness, and without peace. And we will not feel ourselves confident in this life. And God will not hear our prayer. This way, therefore, this is why the watchfulness gives us an opportunity to have God, to acquire God, to be with God. This was a little bit like about all this, and now he's gonna talk about each word in particular. Okay, we have one visitor there too. Now, the word watchfulness comes from the verb to be sober.
Sober.
This is very interesting because in Russian it is same as in Greek. Trizvenie is watchfulness. Trizvenie. This is how it sounds in Russian. And to be sober in Russian, быть трезвым. So it's one root comes, which kind of right away gives a little slightly different and very like definite meaning. So it's like you are sober, you know, spiritually. And you see same in Greek. And watchfulness is a little bit slightly different. It has also talks about the same thing, but from a little different side. So you see in Greek also, it comes from the verb to be sober, which means that I am watching myself very carefully, that I am being vigilant. My soul is not sleeping, but it is alive and it is following someone, something. It's like a little loose here, but he will talk about this in a little bit. But the first meaning of this word, the base meaning of this word, is not to drink wine. So it's very simple. Trezvenie comes from trezvy, sobriety. So if you would translate this word in English the same way, what would it be?
Sober. Sobriety. Yeah.
Sobriety.
Not drunk would be the opposite.
Sobriety.
Or I guess the...
So this could be named like on sobriety and holiness instead, just as an option. And I am not only not drinking, but my abstinence and my strength come to that point that I'm completely not taking anything in my body. I am always fasting because of one and the only one cause, in order to follow someone from the peak, from the capital lake. It means that I am look with watchfulness, with sobriety at someone from the capital letter. I am taking part in his movements in order always to be aware about his actions, about what he is doing. So by this word, watchfulness, we have to understand unceasing vigilance, being awake, which is like a pure activity of our mind. It has nothing to do with anything. It's like watchfulness is here. We finished little part. If you guys maybe have any questions or I'm not being clear, you just raise your hand and we can stop anytime. Again, quote from here, he will repeat some things again and again. So spiritual method, which is in here, is like art. spiritual art. In our daily life, method is the means, is the way, is a system which we follow in order to accomplish something or to reach some goal. This word comes from another verb. I will not even try to pronounce it in English, I mean in Greek, from another verb, which means to follow someone. And you see this applicable more for art, because it's an art when you need a teacher, right? Method, you can use instructions to accomplish something. You know, you get like a, how you call this?
Instructions.
Yeah. When you buy something, you have
manual.
Exactly. You get a manual and you'll be fine.
That's fine.
Yeah. Good, good. In art, it won't work. In art, well, very rarely you have like a very gifted person who can do something by himself. Usually it is following a teacher. And this is why we have this also tradition of that in spiritual life, you would follow someone. You don't do anything by yourself. Okay, if you don't have anyone, fine. You can use manual, like you can read, try to read Holy Fathers, but I don't think you'll go far away. That's why we have spiritual fathers and this is interesting. This is why it applies more to art. So you see, it is, and in Greek even, it is the same root. To follow someone is another Greek word, which I don't know what to say, which means go follow someone. And even like hold someone to his feet in their language, we don't have this, but you know, hold someone's to be very closely, to follow his steps. And in this case, God himself. In case of watchfulness, following him, accompany God. So the word method here is not accidentally used. It gives an exact meaning of the noon watchfulness, which is that I do my task. I do this work not alone and not by myself, but accompanying someone else from big letters. So doing it with God as co-worker. Therefore, a man who, here I don't see really connection, but it's interesting place. Therefore, a man who cannot feel his brother, his neighbor, rejoice together with him, follow him, do something with him, accompany him, who is not communicative, who is like lonely, but only just by himself, enclosed in himself. Such a man of not spiritual, but душевный. Okay, we have again
material,
not really. So yeah, it's like in Russian, I'm always confused how it's in English. You know, there are three stages in our nature: body, soul, and spirit, right? But also we say it's spiritual, carnal, and what is in between?
Well, it's nous, supre.
Yes.
Noetic.
It's like, yeah. It's spiritual. It's highest, right? And then there is a carnal level of body, psychological. I think that's how they translate it. In Russian, it's like level of the soul. When people live just moved by their senses.
The rational reasoning. What's it?
Maybe rational without spiritual,
right,
without this, you know, enlightenment of the spirit.
Yeah.
It's just like your feelings, your emotions, you know, it's more. And I think what I read from Holy Fathers, it's like level of the soul, how animals live.
Yeah,
because they are not, they don't have the reason, they don't have this enlightenment of the spirit which we got from God. So he says here, like this lowliness of the soul, not lowliness of the spirit. And now I know what he's talking about. I'll tell you in a minute. I don't know if he talks this, but this we got from his other book. Such person is not able to perform any watchfulness, who lives on that level. And what he's talking about, why he is saying not spiritual lowliness, because he explains in Mystical Marriage that spiritual lowliness, it's not when you just alone. It's like when you get alone with someone.
Mm-hmm.
And this is, of course, God, you know, so you're just not by yourself. And this, on this level of the soul, of psychological level, if you are alone, you're just alone. This is why it's like difficult and hard. You didn't get yet there. Because of this, our church established monastic institution, monastic life. The highest form of which is being alone with the Lord, the life in the desert. It's like highest kind of level ranks of the monastic life. With him, with whom coexist all church. All churches coexist with God. And this person, special calling, special, very high life is being just alone with God in the desert. People of the world, they are forming a society. And they have different cares and worries about worldly things. They are hunting the literally like the death, the things that are perishing, vain. Not things that don't have any value from spiritual point of view. Something which will perish and disappear as soon as today is gone. And those things are gone with it. That's just temporarily things, which are only exist now. And now, this now, before you pronounce the last letter of this word, is already gone. The world and the image of the world, in some kind of way, is going ahead of things that a person thinks, and therefore his way, the way of the world, is very fast and very shallow. Opposite, the watchfulness, the vigilance of our mind is an activity of our spirit. It is pursuing and following Holy Spirit. It is that high, is that higher, is that something higher way that was granted to the human being by God. Our mind, news here, of course, they're talking about our mind, our spirit, the noetic part of our soul, getting close to God and unite us with him. That's amazing. This is exactly from Unseen Warfare. Mm-hmm. When he says in first chapter, what is the purpose of spiritual life? It is like to get close to God and be united with him. Like same words, like how fathers like talk about the same things. Therefore, this spiritual art or spiritual method means to be for my spirit to be a co-worker with the Holy Spirit. So my spirit works together with Holy Spirit. There is no watchfulness on my own. It is impossible. So when we even start to think about it and approach it probably in the future, because why we're reading this book? I got very excited. I want to try it, you know. I want to get there, you know, and do it. And it doesn't matter. Okay, of course, I am a monk. But, you know, everybody is called to this to some extent. You cannot, monks will be watchfulness. Watchful. Monks will have communion with Holy Spirit. Oh, we are lay people, don't need it. We will be saved like that, like just as is. Everybody need it. That's interesting, right? We have different situations, different circumstances, different path, but the goal is one for everyone. Get close to God and get united with him. Without this, we cannot be saved. So this art, this method is working together with Holy Spirit, finding the ways, you know, to work together. When my spirit, the deep, mysterious places of my being, at this point, they cannot be a part of some other energies. And here he says about uncreated energies, about divine things. We cannot be watchful, you know, practice watchfulness and allowed in our soul some kind of other spirits. And we will see, probably he will talk about this, it connected to thoughts, because thoughts are the vehicles of spirits. We accept thoughts, we accept spirit, which this thought is carrying. So this way, the watchfulness is placing us in front of life of God himself, makes us partakers of Holy Spirit, the creator of my being. For life started at the moment where Holy Spirit wanted it to start, desired it to start. So how did it start? In some unique and a single moment in history, Heavenly Father wanted and brought to the being all created world. After creation, I'm sorry, I don't know how to translate correctly. I use these two words the same way. After creation of this created world, of this visible world, maybe we could say, but it's partly invisible. The angelic invisible world is also created. So you
say after the creation of all things.
Of all things, yeah. Of all things. He, after that, in together, then together with two other hypostases of Holy Trinity, creates human body and breathe in it the breath of life. This way, the creation of God becomes a living soul. Yeah, this is from Genesis. Then God stopped. I'm sorry, I don't have that. You know how he was
rested?
No, he was before things started, he was like kind of floating above the abyss,
moving
about the above the abyss, right? So he stopped that, doing that only, and he started to penetrate in the created things, not only there. So he started to dwell in his creation, and every kinds and in animals. And he is, in a special way, he is entering and dwelling in very unique and high creation, which becomes a king and reason of everything that was created. Reason of all creation, amen. And this is God himself doing. He is coming and dwelling in the man. From that time and further, they go together, God and man. And this union of man and God cannot be even, we cannot even think about it. Think about them separately. Because a man is the image of invisible God. So we cannot think about this image of invisible God without Holy Spirit. Meaning that if there is no Holy Spirit, this image is lost. Let's see, what time is it? Okay, we are close to enough, right, today. We won't get more than 1 hour, right? Probably 1 hour is good. It is a very interesting place. Therefore, Holy Spirit, as one of the hypostases of Holy Trinity, promoting in birth of every man, together with Father and Son, it gives in the mother's womb, the mother, which he is taking from Father and from Mother. And this embryo?
Embryo.
Mm-hmm, becomes a flesh, becomes dust. Earth. This dust is producing a man. As it said in scriptures, dust thou art, and unto dust shalt thou return. Right? This is Genesis again, 3:19. To this dust, parents give their qualities and characteristics of their personalities. Everyone gives a little. Give themselves and give the image of their flesh. The same thing that Heavenly Father made with the first man, he is doing at the moment of birth of every person. So we all created. We are not just born. Every one of us in the moment of the conception is being created by God. With that acceptance that at that time he first created dust, and then he was breathing a Holy Spirit into it. Now, Holy Spirit is entering a man immediately at the time of conception. So you see, the Holy Spirit is right there. That's why we believe, right? That, oh, some people say, oh, it's not man yet. He doesn't have brains. He doesn't. At this very moment, this is already a person. Which means that from first moment, the embryo has life and is a man, is a person. Because he already have presence of Holy Spirit breathed into him. And he has in his nature abilities to be a master of all creation. That's how the purpose we were created. And he is an image of God. And until the last moment of his life, he will carry in himself all the time and in perfection all elements of divine and human nature. There is an inner communion of human and divine natures in the man, similar way like in Christ. This means that at the moment of birth of every one of us, there are existing at the same time, from one side, divine energies, and from the other side, actions of a man. According to the first word and advice of God, be fruitful and multiply. Husband and wife, one person, one man, one flesh, they shall be one flesh. They have communion with Holy Spirit. And the word, Cecilia, an all-powerful word connecting everything together. It enters in the womb of a woman. And this way we are getting the whole man, God and man. I'm sorry, I myself don't get a lot of stuff, but I'm trying to translate as it goes. If you are confused completely, ask questions. We will try to investigate in it. I don't know, maybe that's enough. 554. Or let's finish this little paragraph and we'll stop right here. So this new man created by God and created for God, he is clothed during the baptism, holy baptism, in great in divine life of grace. At the time, while Holy Spirit becomes a destiny of his being. From that time, from Holy Spirit, which is dwelling in the man, and this means that from man himself, are going outside, like spreading unceasingly, like sparks and light of divinity. And this is how the dust of earth because of watchfulness, becomes like a sparkling life. Okay, I will read what I wrote here first, just a second. Yeah, why? Because of watchfulness, because the watchfulness is the pursuing the Holy Spirit. You remember? Yeah. Yeah. So because of watchfulness, we are acquiring Holy Spirit, which is source of life. And that's why we are having this divinity in us, and it starts to, you know, shine. It's like Saint Seraphim said, acquire Holy Spirit and thousands will be saved around, right? Around you. That was about this. You want to read again this last? From this moment, from Holy Spirit, which is dwelling in the man, and it means that from man himself. So in man himself, only because there is a Holy Spirit, because they united with God, unceasingly are going like sparks and light of divinity. So if we acquire Holy Spirit, this is why we say in Orthodox Church, you know, this is why we are not going knocking in the doors and giving like brochures, like, you know, inviting everybody to right? We are trying to acquire, to like bring this, we are knocking in the doors of our own heart, first of all. And if you acquire Holy Spirit, the divine light will start to shine from you that way that it will attract, you know, who God wants to bring. So this way, the dust of earth, because of the watchfulness, becomes the sparkling life. Whew, I think that's enough, because I think, you know, this is, he starts a little more from theory, right? I suspect, I didn't read myself, like to say truth, I do these readings from egoistic point of view. I just don't have time to read this, and I want to read it so much. And when I need to translate it and like explain, it's like so much, you know, more rich becomes, and I can get myself very deep, much more deeply. So I suspect that it will talk more about practical things, about prayer, about how to approach, how to do this, what we have to pay attention to, and things like this. But first he starts from some theory and like theology, so we to understand what we are approaching and have some little understanding. Okay, any questions? If there are any questions, you can ask, or maybe, I actually forgot about this. If any questions, maybe in Zoom, somebody has. Not much people. Okay, if there are no questions, or maybe if you will have questions next time, maybe you think about it and ask something next time. Anything?
I was thinking about what you said, how he's starting from a theological perspective. And it seems like, Lord have mercy. It seems like it seems fairly easy. If you're going to be watchful, you can't just watch for nothing. You have to watch for something or watch for someone, like he's saying, to that capital S, mm-hmm. like someone. And how he draws, other Aemilianos draws you into, if you're watching for someone, then that someone becomes your like everything. Everything is, all your energy is put towards that person. Just like I think about, it's a terrible analogy, I think, but like if you have animals, if you have dogs, right? The dogs, they kind of watch for you all day. If you leave, they wait for you to come back. They lay down.
I think that's a very good analogy. that's how we have to be.
I'm like a dog.
Our master, exactly. That's like, oh, he left. Wow. Yeah. Like Saint Silouan.
Yeah. Yeah,
if Grace left, he was just, this is the only thing he was occupied with. Like, Lord, I'm just missing you. I'm waiting. When are you going to come back? Exactly like this dog sitting and waiting for his master, you know?
And he's such a good example too, Saint Silouan, because he talks about that, attracting the grace of the Holy Spirit, or, you know, pushing the Holy Spirit away. But to your point, like the loneliness that Elder Aemilianos talks about, how someone who's just in the world psychologically and is lonely,
that's pretty hard.
Yeah, it's hard, and there's no relief from that. And so when he talks about in the text there, you said, talks about the spiritual or the noetic loneliness, like of maybe the highest calling of being a hermit, that those people are never lonely, like, or maybe God would allow them to experience some loneliness, but like, you know, how he pulls you along, like sometimes a little distance and then brings you close.
Yeah, but it's interesting that we were talking about this more when we were reading Mystical Marriage.
Yeah.
But this is important to understand for us, that when he talks about the desert and mm-hmm. those very high callings, he is talking about the fullness of it.
Yeah.
Like your all your life is just life alone with God.
Yeah.
But for all of us, to some extent, or at some times of the day, you know, when we supposed to read our prayers, or do our prayer rule, this is for us time of desert.
Yeah.
We have to be in our room alone. Prefer, well, in the family, some prayers you do together, but some you must do on your own.
Yeah.
And this time when you get alone with God, it may be 5 minutes, 10 minutes, or but it half hour, whoever who wants to do what. But this is a very important thing. That's how we learn to be with God.
And I think there's two deserts too. There's that desert of the being alone with God and nothing else matters. And then there's that the period, or can be those times in your life where you feel like you're wandering in the desert. Where is God? Where's God? You know, like that. But anyway, to that point, I think he does a really good job. I mean, of course, because he's Elder Aemilianos, but he does a wonderful job of laying out that without God, there is no life. Like, there was no life in Adam before breath. There was no life in in the egg and the sperm of, you know, creation. There's no life until God breathes life. So
until the Holy Spirit comes. So basically what we got from this, what we read today, that this watchfulness we are going to read about, it is why it is more art than method, like if you take it in English, because you need someone else. This will be work with someone else, and this will be work. Goal will be acquire this Holy Spirit and live in Holy Spirit, live in God, be alive in your soul. And through this, we are getting salvation, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's enough for today. Thank you, everyone. I hope it was not too terrible for English speaking ear. Okay, well, I tried my best. Okay, let's pray then.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Достойна есть Якова истину, блажите тя Богородицу, пресноблаженную и пренепорочную, и Матерь Бога нашего, честнейшую Херувим, и славнейшую без сравнения Серафим, без истления Бога Слово Рошую, сущую Богородицу тебя величать.